Hello everybody, today we are going to see some problems from the areas of parallelograms and triangles. Okay, so first problem is, in a parallelogram ABCD, AB is equal to 8 cm. The altitudes corresponding to sides AB and AD are respectively 4 cm and 5 cm. Find AD. Okay, so here figure is given, parallelogram ABCD. Okay, altitudes are given, this is 4 cm, this is 5 cm. Okay, and we have to find out AD, length of AD. Okay, this is we need to find out. Understood? So now what we need to do? We know that the area of parallelogram. Okay, what is area of parallelogram? Area of parallelogram. Which formula we use? Base into height. Okay, so base into corresponding altitude. Height means what? Corresponding altitude also we can say. Corresponding altitude. Okay. So, if area of parallelogram, this is area of parallelogram is equal to area of parallelogram ABCD is equal to, if suppose we will take height, base AD, then height, what will be the height? NB, because that is given. Okay. So, NB. Okay, this is, or also we can say area of parallelogram ABCD. If we will take base this AB, that time what is the height of this? If AB is the base, then DM is the height. DM is the height. Okay, means area of parallelogram ABCD is this AD into NB, and the same area of parallelogram ABCD we can use AB into DM. So finally we can compare them, AD into NB. We can equate them, AB into DM. Okay, so what is AD? AD we need to find out. NB, what is NB given? 5 cm. So is equal to AB. AB is given 8 cm. Here it is given 8 cm. So that we can put, and DM. DM is given 4 cm. Okay, so AD is equal to 8 multiplied by 4 upon 5. So 8 fours are 32 upon 5 cm. Okay, so 32 upon 5 we can write, 5, 6 are 30, remain 5, 4 are 20. So 6.4 cm is the length of AD. Okay, so this is the first example. Now we will see one more example here. ABCD is a quadrilateral and BD is one of its diagonal. ABCD is a quadrilateral. This is ABCD. Is a quadrilateral and BD is the one of the diagonal as shown in the figure. Show that quadrilateral ABCD is parallelogram and find its area. Okay, what we need to show? ABCD is a parallelogram, that we need to show. Okay, and its area also we need to find out. So one thing we need to do here, that is parallelogram ABCD is a parallelogram, is what we need to show. Opposite sides are equal and parallel. Okay, here one thing is given, 2.5, and this is also given 2.5. This is DB. Okay, BD is the one of its diagonal as shown in figure, and again they have told us this is 90 degree. CDB and ABD are 90 degree. Okay, so what we can say from the figure, the transversal, which is the transversal here, transversal DB intersecting a pair of lines, that which is line, pair of lines DC and AB, DC and AB. Okay, how it is intersecting? So here we can write such that angle CDB is equal to angle ABD is equal to 90 degree. Means here alternate interior angles are equal. If alternate interior angles are equal, then we can say CD is parallel to AB. Okay, so CD is parallel to AB because these are two alternate angles also. Alternate angles. And if alternate angles are equal, then we can say lines are parallel. Okay, if lines are parallel, that time what we can say? We can write there DC, and here one more thing they have given us, DC is equal to AB is equal to 2.5. okay, lines are parallel and lines opposite sides are equal, okay. So we can say quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, this is enough information to show quadrilateral is parallelogram. Now what we can see here, we need to find out area of parallelogram. Okay, so area is equal to base into height. Okay, so what is base? Base, suppose we will take 2.5. That time this is given, DB is the height because it is perpendicular. So DB is given 4 cm. So 2.5 into 4 cm. So 2.5 into 4 is 10 cm or unit square. Okay, centimeter square. Okay, so this way we can find out easily area and base with the properties of parallelogram. Okay, see here our next example. This is from NCERT book. If E, F, G and H are respectively the midpoints of the sides AB, BC, CD and DA. Okay, here it is given ABCD. Okay, what is given? E, F, G and H. E, F, G and H are the respectively midpoints of the sides AB, BC, CD and DA of parallelogram ABCD. Show that the quadrilateral EFGH, quadrilateral EFGH is a parallelogram and its area is half of the area of the parallelogram ABCD. Okay, so for this we need to do some construction first. Okay, see everybody figure. So first construction, we will do two things we need to show. EFGH, EFGH is a parallelogram and area is half of the area of parallelogram ABCD. This area is equal to half of the parallelogram area of ABCD. Okay, so first thing we need to do here, construction. So that construction I am doing here. What is the construction? First we will do join AC and BD, means this diagonals we need to join. Okay, join AC and BD. Okay, AC and BD we need to join. Okay, so here suppose this point, intersection point, we will say O. Okay, so first what is given? F and G are the midpoints. F and G are the midpoints of BC and CD. Okay, construction what we have done? Join AC and BD. Okay, then F and G are the midpoints of BC. F is the midpoint of this and BC, and G is the midpoint of CD. Okay, so from this what we can say? FG is parallel to BD. Okay, FG is parallel to DB. Okay, FG and DB is parallel. Okay, and EH is also parallel to DB. So we can say EH is parallel to DB. Okay, so from this we can say EH is parallel to FG. EH is parallel to FG. If one pair of opposite side is parallel, then we can say, from this we can say directly, we can prove EF is parallel to GH. EF is parallel to GH. How we can prove? If EF is parallel to AC and GH is parallel to AC, then we can say GH and FE are parallel to each other. So similarly we can say here, we can prove EF is parallel to GH. If opposite sides of a quadrilateral are parallel, then we can say this quadrilateral is a parallelogram. So quadrilateral, here from this we can say quadrilateral EFGH is a parallelogram. Okay, so this was the first question. This was the first question and that proof we have given. Okay, now we will think about the second. What is second question? and its area is half of the area of the parallelogram ABCD. Okay, so what we need to do here, what is the to prove? What is to prove? We need to prove that area of parallelogram, area of parallelogram EFGH is equal to half of the area of parallelogram ABC. This is we need to prove. Okay, this is our target. This we need to prove. So for this also we need to do some construction. Okay, so what is the construction we need to do? Construction join OF, join OF means this OF. Okay, OF OG. Then OH, OH and H. Means in short, we have taken the diagonals of parallelogram EFGH. Okay, so join OF, OH, OG and OE. Okay, so this we have taken. Now what is we are going to do here? See, here see, from this we can say FO is parallel. FO is parallel to BA. Okay, this is FO which is parallel to BA. This side, this is parallel to this. Understood? So from this we can say FO is parallel to CG. If FO is parallel to AB, then we can say FO is parallel to CG, because this is parallelogram. ABCD is a parallelogram. Already opposite sides are parallel. So FO is parallel to AB, then we can say FO is parallel to CG. Okay, FO is parallel to CG. And FO is equal to half of AB. Half of AB. FO is equal to half of AB. So we can say half of FO is equal to half of CD also. Okay, half of CD is equal to CG. Half of CD is equal to CG. Okay, so from this is enough. So we can say from this quadrilateral OFCG is a parallelogram. OFCG, this quadrilateral is a parallelogram. Understood? So after this, if this is C, if here I am saying this is P, we will say this in intersection point S, this we will say R, and this we will say Q. Understood? So OP and PC are equal. Why equal? OP and PC are equal because diagonals of parallelogram, this is also a parallelogram, okay, and diagonals of parallelogram bisect each other. So here we can write diagonals of parallelogram bisect each other. Okay, so this is OP is equal to PC. Now I'm taking next further. See, now triangles OPF, which triangle? OPF and triangle, second triangle will CPF, in triangle OPF and triangle CPF. Okay, OPF and CPF have equal base. Okay, what is equal base? OP and PC are equal, so bases are equal. So here we can write have equal basis. Equal basis. Hence their altitudes are also same. Okay, if bases are equal, both the bases are equal, so altitudes are also same. So in this condition we can say area of triangle OPF is equal to area of triangle CPF. OPF is equal to CPF. Okay, this is we have. Now similarly, what we can say? Similarly, we can say area of triangle OQF, OQF is equal to what will be answer? Area of triangle BQF. BQF, this is Q. Okay, BQ, this area is equal. We have given this and this area is equal, so these two areas are equal. Similarly we can say, so not necessary to show again this. Understood? So this is one thing we have. Okay, Now we suppose we will add this both. By adding both, by adding, what we will get here? Area of triangle OPF plus area of triangle OQF is equal to area of triangle CPF. Here this is CPF. CPF plus area of triangle BQF. The sum of these two. OPF plus OQF means this quadrilateral is coming. Okay, so this is a parallelogram. Understood? Again, this is a parallelogram. So for this we can write area of parallelogram OQFP is equal to area of triangle CPF plus area of triangle BQF. Area of this sum is area of triangle parallelogram OQF. I told you this and this sum is OQFP. So instead of this two, we have taken OQFP is equal to RHS is same. Okay. So similarly we can show. Similarly, we can write area of parallelogram OPGS. OPGS. Okay. OPGS. See where it is. OPGS. What we have done here, sum of this is equal to this plus this. Okay, this plus this. So like that, OPGS is equal to this plus this. Understood? So directly now we can take. So OPGS is equal to area of triangle GPC plus area of triangle DSG. Okay, see here GPC and DSG. Okay, so this is our second thing. Now I'm taking third thing here downside, that is area of parallelogram OSHR is equal to this plus this. So DSH triangle is equal to area of triangle DSH plus area of triangle HAR means this triangle. Okay, like that we can say area of triangle OREQ. See OREQ, this area is equal to sum of these two. Okay, so that I am taking here area of triangle parallelogram OREQ is equal to area of triangle ARE plus area of triangle EQB. Okay, so these four things we have. This is one, this is we will say second one, third one, and this is fourth one. Okay, so now what we are going to do? We are going to do addition. Now see, we have taken first this quadrilateral, okay, that is here. Then we have done this is, that is second one, then third one here, and fourth one is remaining here. Means sum of these four, what is going to come? HEFG. So that I am taking, instead of that directly I am taking now. So by adding okay, LHS suppose we will add, then what we will get? HEFG, area of parallelogram HEFG is equal to what is going to come? This is equal to this two. Okay, then this is equal to this two, this quadrilateral is equal to this two. Okay, this and this, and then this and this. Okay, so what is going to come here finally? Area of triangle, this addition is going to come, area of triangle FCG plus area of triangle GDH plus area of triangle HAE plus area of triangle EBF by adding. Okay, see here FCG means this plus this is going to come FCG plus GDH means this. Okay, then HAG, sum of these two is going to come HAE plus FBE. Understood this four? Okay. So from this we can say a half of this is the half of parallelogram ABCD. Okay. So this is area of half of parallelogram ABCD, because half went here and half is this. So half of parallelogram ABCD. So hence we have given here proof, area of parallelogram HEFG is equal to half of parallelogram ABCD. Okay. So this is the simple proof. See carefully, only a little bit theoretical part is more. Okay, but concept you must understand. So see this and solve in your notebook. Thank you. Okay, see here our next problem. This is also I have taken from the NCERT. P and Q are any two points lying on the sides DC. See here, P and Q are two points lying on the sides DC and AD respectively of a parallelogram ABCD. Of a parallelogram ABCD, show that area of triangle APB is equal to area of triangle BQC. BQC. Okay, this we need to show. Okay, so here see, we need to do some construction here. What is construction? What is the construction that we need to do here? That is, we need to draw from point P a perpendicular from point P. Okay, suppose this is, we will take perpendicular. Okay, and here also we are going to take a perpendicular from point Q on BC. This is perpendicular. Okay, suppose now we are going to find out here area of triangle APB. Area construction we need to mention. P, suppose here I am giving L and here I am giving M. Construct or draw PL perpendicular to AB and QM perpendicular to BC. QM perpendicular to BC. Okay. So now area of triangle APB. Area of triangle APB. Area is equal to half into base into height. Okay. What is base? AB. And what is height? What is height? PL. Okay. So half into, suppose we are thinking about AB and this is a parallelogram. Okay, this is a parallelogram. What is the formula of parallelogram? Area of parallelogram, base into height. Okay, so here base and this is height of that parallelogram. Okay, this is the height of this parallelogram also, and this is one side, so that we can consider as a base. Understood? So AB into PL we can consider area of parallelogram ABCD. Okay, so this is, I am saying this is first one. Now the same principle we need to use here. Okay, so area of triangle BQC is equal to half into what is base BC into height QM. Height is QM. If this is for parallelogram also we need to use the same formula, base into height. Okay, so this is half into BC into QM, we can take half area of parallelogram ABC. Okay, so this is second one. So here also half into parallelogram of ABCD and half into area of parallelogram of ABCD. So from first and second, from 1 and 2, we can say area of triangle APB is equal to area of triangle BQC. Okay, and that only they are asking us. Understood? So this was very simple proof. Okay, such type of sums we need to do. Solve these examples and solve, do the practice from NCERT textbook. Okay, thank you very much.